In this video, I'll show how to set up an open source historian using Grafana and InfluxDB. If you haven't seen Grafana, it's a really nice looking web-based dashboard system. If you go onto their website, you can view the live demo to get an idea of what it looks like, but they're really nice looking graphs. You can zoom in on your data very easily, and it ties into a lot of different data sources. And in this case, we're going to be using InfluxDB. This is a time series database, and it's a very high performance, really built for web applications. But it has a lot of SQL-like capabilities, and it can handle millions of data points per second. And the retention policies will drop off old data as needed. So in this example, we'll be using a Raspberry Pi 3, and we'll be using Docker to just quickly bring down the Grafana and InfluxDB images. We'll also use Node-RED to bring in our Modbus data from our 352 coupler. And you can see the dashboard is being served up by Grafana. And we'll also show at the end Owago PFC using curl post commands to get data into the database. So here's our PFC 200, here's our Raspberry Pi 3, and this is our coupler with the Modbus interface. We also have a RTD wired to the input module. So we'll start by SSHing into our Raspberry Pi, which is running the latest Raspbian. The first thing we'll need to do is pull Docker and install that as shown here. Once this is done installing, you'll need to reboot your Pi and then just log back into the Pi. We need to add the Pi user to our Docker so we can issue Docker commands without having to use sudo. Then what we'll do is we'll create a Docker network. This will allow all our images to talk to each other over a dedicated network. That's done this way. Then we'll use the Docker run command to pull the latest Grafana off the internet. Once this is done installing, it'll actually run the Grafana image, and we want to do some changes to the way we call this. We want to basically name it and assign it to a network that we created earlier. So it gives us a random name. We just want to stop that random name, and then we'll remove that image. Next, we'll create a volume called Grafana Storage, and we'll use that volume when we instantiate our container. So here you can see the command Docker run with our image name called Grafana and our network's Wago. And then we can issue the Docker container ls command to make sure that the image ran correctly and has the right settings. So if you point your web browser to the IP address of the Pi, :3000, then you can log into Grafana using admin. And you can see all the different data sources that are supported out of the box. We'll be using InfluxDB as mentioned earlier, so let's go ahead and install that Docker image. So as you can see, this command will pull the influx Docker image as well as the configuration file from the internet automatically. If we do an ls, you can see it created the config file in our home directory, and we can use nano to edit that. In this case, we're going to go with all the default settings to make it easy. So now we can see that the image has downloaded okay. We can go ahead and use the Docker run command to start our InfluxDB Docker image. We can do that with this command as shown here. And once that's done, now we can actually start interacting with the database using a curl command. So we're going to create the database called MyDB. We can insert data called MyVar with a timestamp. And then we can actually query the database as well. So you can see that data point showed up right there. Now that we know the database is working, we can go back into Grafana and add the InfluxDB container here. We want to disable TLS verify, and then we'll put in our database name here of MyDB. When you click Save and Test, it should say data source is working. So now we'll use Node-RED to insert data into our database. We're going to use the inject just to insert some test data. We're going to use a number 100, and then using the palette manager, you can install the influx palette. And then I'm just going to drop in the influx insert. Here we can map it to our influx Docker container in the database there, and type in a measurement name. I'm going to call this test value, and we'll make a couple more buttons with some different values, and I'll click these. And we can also query the database to make sure those inserts worked. We're going to configure this to select everything from that topic that we are inserting into. And we'll map that to a debug window. And here are our three objects for each of the three button pushes. Now we can add that data into our dashboard. If we go into Manage Dashboards, create a new dashboard, and then edit it, we can change the data source to InfluxDB. It will automatically show any tags that are available. And that's it. We can go back, and you can see the data is populating in the graph. So if I click the button a few more times and then I go back to the graph, now we have to change this to the last 5 minutes, and you can see all those new button pushes. You can also change the refresh rate, so it'll automatically update every 5 seconds. So now we'll drop in a Modbus master node. We'll use function code 3 and we'll read address 1. This is basically going to read the RTD that's on our coupler. That value comes in multiplied by 10, so we need to divide it by 10 in a function. And if we monitor that in a debug window, you can see the values coming in. So we'll just copy our influx node, and we'll rename the test value. We'll call it myTemp. Now we have some real process data we can look at in Grafana. We'll just add a new chart, and if we go to edit that chart, we can select the data source to the InfluxDB, and we can find our tag, which is myTemp. We can go ahead and view that, refresh it every 5 seconds, and you can see our temp is coming in. If I put my hand on the RTD to warm it up, you can see the value is changing. Grafana has a lot of advanced features. If you go into edit the chart, you can add averages to the chart. You can set conditions which generate alarms if the variable goes above or below a certain point. And you can name the panels. Just a lot of features that I'm just scratching the surface here. You can also export the series to a CSV file right from the web browser for offline viewing. Now we'll show how easy it is to use the WAGO PFC200 to insert data into the influx. Well, you need to start by installing curl. So in the web-based management, you can upload the curl IPK and then reboot the controller. So then in eCockpit, you can see this very simple program that generates that curl command and then calls it from the Linux command line. To do that, we're using the sysprocess library. There's an execute command 2 that lets you pass a command line to the Linux shell. So this is the function that basically concatenates all of our tags and creates the string. So if I go ahead and download this program, and if I inspect the string that we're sending, you'll recognize that's very similar to the very first test string that we did to insert data into the table. It's basically just an HTTP post command. So if we go back into Grafana and edit this test panel, we'll tie this to the InfluxDB database, and we'll choose the My Button tag coming from the WAGO PFC. That's it. So we can see the sawtooth pattern coming in. I came back the next day just to see how quickly it loads with more data. It's really amazing how quickly it loads, going even back 12 hours. There's no delay in the loading. So this is a really easy way to implement an open source historian using InfluxDB and Grafana. I hope you've enjoyed the video. Thank you.